October 4th to October 10th, World Mental Health Week. October 10th is celebrated as World Mental Health Awareness Day, and the whole of October is celebrated as the day that we remember that mental health is as important as physical health. Having said this, mental illness worldwide is the most stigmatized illness amongst all illnesses. The WHO states that very soon, depression and suicide are going to overtake cardiac illness as the world's number one killer. 1 in 4 in the world have mental illness. 1 in 8 attempt suicide. Children between the ages of 15 to 19 have started committing suicide, and that rate is increasing rapidly. Last year alone, more than 10,000 people between the ages of 15 and 19 committed suicide due to study stress in India. Staggering, isn't it? But with all this, what is the effect that mental illness has on us? Before that, I'd like to talk about the amount of information that is available. Today we have a psychiatric movement, a psychological movement, an awareness drive, and an anti-psychiatric movement. There are people, for every person who says that please take help, psychiatric help is available, there are only 4,000 or max 5,000 psychiatrists for the whole of India. So 5,000 is to 1.4 billion population, which means probably one mental health professional for every 1.8 lakh people. What do you say to that? And they're even less qualified counselors and psychologists. So, a huge dearth of mental health professionals in our country. But then, everybody on their own, in their own right, becomes a mental health professional. And I'll tell you why. But today, we have a lot of handheld, extremely smart devices that give us information. Lots of chat rooms that people enter and talk about their symptoms, and then immediately you have a diagnosis in hand. So today, when a person approaches you, they don't approach you with a thought that says, please help me. I have people who approach me saying, oh, I think I have OCD, or I think I have, you know, a mood disorder. Could you help me? And I don't want medicines. So with all the information, let me tell you the good parts first. A, you have a lot of understanding. B, you're able to arrive at some kind of a conclusion as to what's wrong with you. C, it's also something that you can also help a mental health professional say, these are what I've been feeling over time and I've recorded them, and maybe you can help me. 4, there are a lot of apps that help you. What are the cons? You come with a diagnosis which may not be yours. You're completely convinced that something terrible is wrong with you. You contradict doctors, refuse medication. All of this information is available on the net. Again, and the last thing, which is probably the most important, is that though there are lots of apps, people who use them are very few. So these are the pros and cons. Also, the films that portray mentally ill people as manics, throwing flowers, tearing their clothes up, and not showing real symptoms. People making fun of mental illness as if it's something that is terrible. And of course, the never-ending stigma that exists worldwide for mental illness. All of these things can seriously hamper health-seeking behavior and help-seeking behavior.